Hey everybody, welcome back. It's Chewy. And I think we're here in episode 5 of all the Mod 7. And, I don't know exactly what happened, but my world corrupted. And I had to start from scratch. Not from scratch, but, so it gave me one of the backups, which had a lot of it, but not quite all of it. So I did my best to reconstruct everything. I think we're close to where I was before. So, let's go from there. Alright, so I was looking at some of these thermal machines, right? So, magma crucible. I might as well make a couple. All right, another bricks. Do I not have another rack? No, oh, must have lost that as well. Oh. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time. Basically, I just need to get enough to make the machines, so quick dash, and we're back. All right. Oh. There we go. So I'm looking at jetpacks as well. I think might be able to get certain level, a couple of levels in. All right, so the wooden one. So I don't have any idea how many of these I need, so let's go for 32. Okay. Let's do... We're missing... Alright, let's see what else we can do. Right. I'm missing one leather. All right. I had one of those wild in things, whatever you call them. Nope, apparently not. What about trying? Okay, not the electric one. I'm pretty sure I saw. Yep. Oops. Okay, I need shears. Take time. All right, come on. Okay, so. Yeah, I might as well make the squeezer too. So, I think if the recipe works, perfect. It gives us leather. All right. Oh, back to the jetpacks. Oops. All right. So this is tier one also. No, that's tier zero. Okay. So stone is tier two. This require has to be andesite. Okay, that's kind of bizarre. Um, I have anisite. All right, so apparently I have to keep it in my inventory. Okay, what's next? Silver. I do not have a lot of silver. And this, we're going to wind up losing. Let's see. Find out how much I got left here. Okay, that's a full block. And 2 blocks, 5 ingots. Two. Three. Okay. That in there. All right. Nope. All right, we'll go to 16 for now. And then that one. Now I think we have one. Okay, perfect. Next round. Oh, jeez. Next is Electrum. Let's see. So there's 4 ingots there. 6 more is 10. Each of these is 2, so 12, 14, 16. Twenty-four ingots. So 24 electrum. Huh. I may not have enough. Let's see. All right, so we'll let that work. And let's figure out a way to charge that jetpack. Let's see, Sterling, Darling. Can we charge here? We can. Noise. Noise. That works. Excellent. Okay. Let's see. No idea what the controls are. Nice. So the hover is kind of, I don't know, not really. I mean, it's not terribly slow. I mean, obviously the more you get, you know, the higher the upgrade that you get, the less likely, or, you know, the less slower the descend as you're hovering. Nice to have all that sugar. That took me a while. All right. Magnet's working. Can this go in a bobble? Nope. Huh. What's a bundle slot? Looks like there's something in it already, but oh well. I don't see what's there. Okay. This is good. We have a decent jetpack. We have a charger. Pretty good. Let's go back to working on, I was working on the thermal machines. Oh. That's why I needed nether bricks. Okay, 1, 2, 2, 4. Why not? In case we want to make another. What are we missing? Glass. All right, sand. I need more than that. Right. So do that, and then... Sweet. We're going to do the magma crucible induction smelter pulverizer and redstone furnace. And the reason I wanted the pulverizer and the induction smelter is I'm not a huge fan of the smeltery, and you can double ore with the pulverizer, and the induction smelter can get you into the steel production instead of having to do an immersive engineering blast furnace. So it's just basically coal dust and the coal in the pulverizer give you coal dust, and then and add that to iron, and that gives you steel. So yeah, sweet. All right, now we're gonna need more of those for sure. Bingo. So magma crucible. So we're gonna have to find and figure out what to do for power for that. Now that is gonna be certainly interesting. Induction smelter. Alright, so let's go back to our Ingmar. Blast furnace. That's going to require sand. Oops. Don't have machine frame. Gotcha. Well, now. Okay. There we go. Let's grab another one. So we need 4 glass for a machine frame. So I already have one of those. Piston. Oh, missing copper. Copper. Maybe copper ingot. Nope. Almost there, dude. I almost let him out. He would have been able to get away. There we go. And what did I need? 8? Yeah, 8. We have time in a bottle. I probably asked that already. Nope, we don't. Oh well, it is what it is. So redstone furnace. I think the fluid encapsulator is probably worth making. Need a bunch more copper. But that's fine. Oh wow, so this is, wait a minute. Yeah, that's the cheaper version. Okay. Okay, so Almost. Right, so there's pulverizer. Right. Now, the redstone furnace, so we need another. Just for kicks, I'm just gonna grab the other furnace. I mean, now that everything's out here, I really don't. And too much cooking or smelting in there for the regular furnaces, anyway. Okay, now we're cooking with gas. All right. Ugh. Don't know what that is. Oh, did I get leather in there? Nice. Totally forgot about that. Okay, so we need to smelt. Let's finish that out. And then this one. Knock these two out. So each one, four. Okay. We need eight total, four from each. I was thinking about it, but I made some earlier for I made that kitchen sink. Yeah, to make. I forget. That's where I remember using the clay there, but I don't remember exactly what I did with it. Okay. We now have a basic set of thermal. So the magma crucible, induction smelter, pulverizer, and redstone furnace. And I guess we probably have time to do the fluid encapsulator too. Oops. Boom. And there's our fluid encapsulator. Perfect. All right. So we get that going. Going. I'll leave some in clay form just in case we need it. Whoops. Boom. Looks like it's going. Sun's going down. All right. How do I want to set this up? I want to put some more, I want to make some more strainer. Okay, I think I can probably remember it. It's the other way around. So it's four strings, okay. Bingo. Start those up again. All right. So yeah, what am I gonna do? I wanted to. So, I guess put it. So, jeez. The worst place, worst block placement in a while. Okay, see this little trough? That's where you want to line up the drying basin with on the squeezer, right? So if we do our, oh man, I swear. All right, and then we also need lever. On a button. Okay. So apparently, where is the one? Yeah, this one. Right? Yeah, that's the one I want. Here we go. Nice. Magnet stops all the crows from grabbing. okay. Let's see. There we go. Now we have a button. So, what to do? Actually, I need to take this out. Is you jump on top of the squeezer and. Press the button to load it up again. Then that gets you a block of crystallized mineral. So, I'm just going to leave this here for now. We'll eventually build this up real quick, but for now, let's figure out the power for all of our industrial foregoing machine or sorry, thermal machine. So I did make all the pipes. I made 16 of each. I do have that. Oops. Get rid of that. Here. Put that in there. All right. So now I just need to figure out what's going to power this thing. Now, is there a pump? Well, this isn't super expensive. We would need another obsidian. So we could. All right. All right. Sweet. All right, that's enough for now. All right, so I really don't understand why this thing won't pick up sticks. I guess it's probably not ready for prime time. Oh, we need another bucket. And that means flying back. All right, so let's see if we can make it now. And great. Okay, now magnetic. So let's I can't remember if I had any lava down below. Like, I haven't found big pools yet. Lava. No, nothing here. Down here. You know what? Let's just see what's here. We can't look into a lava pool here somewhere. The range upgrade is crazy. All right, so let's put the jetpack on while we go exploring this. And of course, I've lost where I came in. I'm not gonna waste too much more time on it. Well, we can try and get it set up this way. Oop, you know what though? I'm gonna need I'm gonna need two ender tanks. Oh crap. This is just the most bizarre thing ever. I don't even get it. It's like, inner bucket, inner tank. So we need four blaze rods, two obsidian, a bucket, and wool. Okay, how about just a tank to fill? Okay, so I am going to need a bucket and fluid pipe. I don't know why I haven't been doing the teleporting. Kind of dumb. Anyway, let's see. Okay, so it's pumping, but it's filling up. It looks like it's filling its it's filling the looks like it's gonna fill that internal buffer first. Not. No, that's not it either. So it's pumping. pumping lava. Let me see. Okay, be right back. I'm gonna look this up real quick. Okay, so I was somewhat correct. So this has to be over top of it, not in it. That's why I wasn't able to find anything. However, this is horribly inefficient and slow. So we do have a full. This will continue to run. It'll pull what it needs of lava out first, and then it dumps it into this. But the excess goes into the storage tank. So we've got 3.5 buckets in there and a full magmatic dynamo. That's not going to cut it. However, for now, at least I understand how the setup works and I can get this done. So what I'm going to do is eventually I'm going to get into the nether. And I'm going to use one of the big giant pools in there. And hopefully I don't get killed in the meantime. But for now, that looks like a good place to stop. I really appreciate you watching, and go ahead and like, comment, subscribe, and let me know what you're thinking in the comments below. Thanks again.